Hey everybody, happy Thursday. Okay, so I'm going to be doing something a little bit different today. I'm going to be offering some mini lessons for you guys that you guys get to pick what you want to watch and take a quiz over. So this is something that maybe you're struggling with, maybe something that you'd like extra help with. So if we look back at Tuesday's quiz, the last question, I took a survey, just like Ms. Shadowin takes surveys in the gym in the mornings, and she'll ask you, what's your favorite ice cream? Raise your hand if it's chocolate, raise your hand if it's strawberry, raise your hand if it's vanilla. This is the same thing. I asked you, when it comes to learning about fractions, what do you think you could use more practice with? A couple of you guys said comparing fractions. Well, that's the mini lesson that you are on right now. If you're one of those friends that said, I need more help with comparing fractions, this is the video for you. I had a couple of friends that say fractions on a number line is what they'd like to revisit. I had some friends say adding and subtracting fractions. And then I had a lot of friends say improper to mix numbers. Okay, so if you're a friend that you think I need extra help with comparing fractions, you are in the right spot. Now, here's the kicker. There's going to be 4 videos on NTI Day 12. You only have to watch 1 video and take 1 quiz. Okay, so I'm going to ask you this. How many videos do you have to watch? 1. You should have said 1. How many quizzes do you have to take for Thursday, NTI Day 12? 1. Okay, so we shouldn't have any confusion. You shouldn't be like, Miss Mallory, I have to watch all 4 videos and take all 4 quizzes. No, you weren't watching my video then very closely. You have to watch 1 video and take 1 quiz. Okay, so you would take the quiz over comparing fractions. Everybody clear with that? All right, let's go ahead and work on comparing fractions. Example number 1. I have, turn this a little bit, there we go, 1/6 compared to 2/10. Now, the easy way when it comes to comparing fractions is to cross multiply. Okay, so let's do that. Change it to yellow. We start from left to right, top to bottom. I've got 1 times 10 is 10. Okay. Then I go to the other side. 6 times 2 is 12. Well, I know that 10 is less than 12. So I know that 1/6 is less than 2/10. We can also do this by drawing it out. Okay. This method is not necessarily the best method or the most reliable. But if you're a visual learner, this might be the way that you like to go. Oops. So I make sure that both of my drawings are the same size. So that's what that box is. I just went ahead and split it. One box I'm going to try to put in 6 equal pieces, and the other I'm going to try to do 10 equal pieces. So let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that's not very equal. Let me try that again. Need a little bit bigger spaces. This is why drawing it out is not the best method, because sometimes our drawings aren't exactly even. It's hard to compare, especially when you have this close of fractions. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, that's a little bit better. Okay, so I'm going to do blue 1/6. So I've got 1/6 here. And then let's do red at 2/10. 1, 2. All right. So even on my 2/10, it still looks bigger in my picture. But with a fraction that is that close, it's really important that you're able to cross multiply. So my picture and my cross multiplication both indicate that 1/6 is in fact less than 2/10. All right, let's do another example. All right, I have 3/4 compared to 8/10. All right, let's go ahead and try that cross multiplication. 3 times 10 is 30. 8 times 4 is 32. Ooh, that's a close one again. But I know that 30 is less than 32, so I would do 3/4 is less than 8/10. Now I could draw this one out as well. Okay, there's my 3/4. My tenths is always harder. Okay. All right. I'm going to do 3/4 in blue. 1, 2, 3. I'll do 8/10 in red. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 and 8. See, in my picture, those look pretty even, and 30 and 32 are really close. So that's why it's important that we know how to cross multiply. Okay, so we know that 30 is, that 3/4 is less than 8/10. That's how we'd read that. All right, another example. This one has some improper fractions on it. Okay, 2 improper fractions. Now, you could change this to mixed numbers, or you can keep them improper fractions. You can still go the cross multiplication route. So let's start with that first. 11 times 2 is 22. 5 times 5 is 25. Again, I know that 22 is less than 25, so I know that 11/5 is less than 5/2. Okay, I could also change this to a mixed number. How many times does 5 go into 11? 5 goes into 11 2 times. I know this because 5 times 2 is 10, and 10 is right underneath 11. I couldn't do 5 times 3. 15 is greater than 11. So I know that my whole number would be 2. 5 times 2 is 10. 11 minus 10, so we do that numerator minus that product. 11 minus 10 gets you 1. That becomes my numerator. My denominator stays the same. All right, let's change 5/2. 2 goes into 5 2 times. 2 times 2 is 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. 1 becomes my numerator. Keep my denominator the same. We have to think we've got the same numerators here, and we talked about that with comparing fractions. Now, we always choose the denominator that's the smallest number, because we know that 1/2, if I took half of a pizza versus 1/5 of a pizza, 1/2 is going to be a whole lot bigger. So I know that 2 1/2 is greater than 2 1/5. So I could read this as 11/5 is less than 5/2, or I could read this as 2 1/5 is less than 2 1/2. I've got 2 more examples for you. We have 4/3 and 6/4. Let's go ahead and cross multiply. 4 times 4 is 16. 6 times 3 is 18. Wow, again, it's less than. I didn't do that on purpose, I promise. All right, I know that 16 is less than 18, so I know that 4/3 is less than 6/4. We can also change this to a mixed number if you feel like that is easier. 3 goes into 4 1 time. 3 times 1 equals 3, so 4 minus 3 equals 1. That becomes my numerator. So I know it's 1 1/3. Over here, how many times does 4 go into 6? It goes into 6 1 time. Then I do 4 times 1 equals 4. 6 minus 4 equals 2. So I have 1 2/4. I could simplify that to 1 1/2. But I'll go ahead and do that actually. I'll go 1 1/2. I know that a slice, half of a slice of pizza versus 1/3 of a pizza is bigger. So I know that 1 1/3 is less than 1 1/2. Could also read this as 4/3 is less than 6/4. All right, let's look at our bonus. Ooh, tough one. We've got a mixed number and an improper fraction. So we have to pick. We got to get them on the same page. Either we got to look at 2 mixed numbers, or we've got to look at 2 improper fractions. I personally would rather look at improper fractions. So let's change our mixed number. We know to change it to an improper fraction, a mixed number to an improper fraction, you have to go multiply the denominator by the whole number. So that means we're doing 2 times 2 is 4. Then we add our numerator, and that would be 5. So I'm going to do that again. You got 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5. So now that becomes my numerator. My denominator stays the same. So I'm looking at 5/2 and 11/8. Let's go ahead and cross multiply that. 5 times 8 is 40. 11 times 2 is 22. Well, I know that five halves has to be greater than 11 eighths because 40 is a lot bigger than 22. You could also draw these out if you wanted to. So I have 5 halves and 11 eighths. I'm going to draw my 11 eighths first. All of this is 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, that's your 11 eighths. And I know that that would really represent 1 and 3 eighths based on my picture. And then 5 halves. I know I need another one right here. Okay, so here'd be 2, 3, 4, 5. So that'd be 1, 2 halves, 2 holes, and then a half. And I know that this is definitely greater than this. So I'm going to go ahead and draw that in. 2 1/2 is greater than 11 eighths. All right, that's a hard one. But if you're able to get the first couple done with me and you know how to follow along to that, then that's all that you need to know, okay? Now I'm going to say it again. You only watch this one video and you only take that one quiz and make sure you take the quiz that says comparing fractions. That's the video you watch is comparing fractions. So you need to take the quiz of comparing fractions. Hope you have a great Thursday. It's almost spring break. Go out and enjoy the beautiful weather. And I appreciate how hard you guys are working for me.